message. There's a real danger in only getting half the message or half the thought. You've probably heard that familiar saying that something is better than nothing. That's not always true. In 1815, there was a great battle for the future of Europe between mostly the British forces led by the Duke of Wellington and France led by the famous general and emperor Napoleon. A ship brought home some news of the great Battle of Waterloo to London, but of course there were no modern electronic means of communication back then, so they used signals with coded flags. The flags would signal a message from the ship to one high point to another, eventually relaying their message across the land. The signalman on the ship got out the word Wellington. A few seconds later, defeated, and then heavy fog encompassed the ship so it could no longer be seen from shore. All across England, the demoralizing, tragic message went out, Wellington defeated, period, full stop. There was great sadness and fear gripping the people. Then something miraculous happened. 3 hours passed, the fog lifted, and the signalman continued the rest of his message. Wellington defeated the enemy. As you can imagine, there was suddenly great rejoicing and gladness all across the country. Yes, the fog lifted. Half of a message is not even half of the truth. The devil is an expert on using half messages. He delights in lies and you being completely defeated by them. He wants you down, not up. He wants you doubting, not believing. He can't stop faith, so he needs you to believe something that is not true. The trick is to make it seem believable and credible. The devil even used portions of scripture to tempt the Lord Jesus in the wilderness. Jesus died on the cross. The disciples were completely demoralized, discouraged, and heartbroken. Did he die? Yes, he had to. But that was not even half of the whole message, and therefore not even half of the truth. Yes, he died, but praise God, he was dispossessing the devil of all authority on earth, taking the keys of death and the grave. The disciples were only getting half the message and therefore none of the truth. The angels that met the women at the grave said, "He is risen. Remember how he told you?" That's in Luke 24, 4-8. Ignorance is a choice weapon of the enemy. Your willingness to take only half of the signal is deadly. Get the whole message. Get the whole truth. Easter is not the truth with only half of the message. You can't quit the story on Good Friday. Yes, Jesus died, but God raised him up from the grave, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for you constantly. If you only believe he died for your sins, you have the picture of great sacrifice by a loving Jesus, but not his triumphant victory over the devil and the curse. We have too many half-believers caught in the doorway of life, sort of in and sort of out. Life cannot be victorious if you don't base it on Christ's entire victory. Life cannot be whole if you don't base it on the whole truth. Jesus said in John 8, verse 32, "You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free." Make a decision today that you want all of God's plan for you. He's got so much good for you. Take it all. Who would want just half a car, half a plane ride, half a parachute? Really? Come on, you can see through the tactics of the chief liar. It's time to take the whole truth, and it will set you entirely free. Today is the day to activate your faith. Let's pray God's word. Jesus, according to your word, we choose to know the whole truth and be entirely set free. You came to give us life and life more abundantly, according to John 10:10. Forgive us, Lord, for being too willing to take only half the story. You said in Isaiah 30:18, "Blessed are those who wait for you." We are blessed when we trust in you, not when we lean on our own sense and reason. Direct us in all of our ways through these challenging times for your name's sake. Amen. Hey, if you're going through difficult circumstances at this time, we want to pray for you personally and help you any way that we can. Please reach out to us on our website at allnationschurch.ca by email or phone. Remember that God loves you, my dear friend. Pam and I, we're praying for you. We love you. In Jesus' name.